Welcome back to the channel, everyone, and today we'll be watching another Internet Historian video. This one is called The Zone Between Area 50 and 52. I wonder what that means. All right, let's get into it. I've been watching some of their more recent stuff, and they actually have real history, so it's not just all internet memes, which is actually kind of fun. So yeah, we're going to take a look at the Fancy series as well as some of their incognito stuff like the Art series and Space series. But yeah, let's get into it. That was pretty funny.
Aliens. They exist. And what's more, they're here and they've been walking among us for millions of years. Just look.
I mean, they probably do, but if they're the ones that hit our planet first, we're all dead. That's just all there is to it. Unless it goes the other way around and we find a planet with them on it.
Cup of the night sky. Each one of those lights is probably an alien. Shoot at them, and the police show up.
Yes, don't shoot at lights in the night sky at random. That's a bad idea.
Coincidence? Break into the CIA, just looking for clues. They put you on a no-fly list. Coincidence? There are no coincidences, only truth bombs, and the government is holding the fuse. Locked up.
Okay. What was that?
Looking for clues.
I love the superimposed, because there's even like shadows now and things like that, so.
They put you on a no-fly list. Coincidence? There are no coincidences, only truth bombs, and the government is holding.
Barack Truth Obama alien cover. Okay.
The fuse locked up tight in Area 51. And so our story begins with one man, Joseph Expedience. On June 21st of the solar year 2019, Joe spoke to a whistleblower.
Right!
Bob Lazard. Now, Bob claims to have worked at...
Isn't this the guy, but isn't there a whole group of people who blame, believe there's a whole section of lizard people under the Earth crust somewhere?
At the Area 51. And so, Joe summoned him to his... sensory deprivation satellite, where he could ask him probing questions about that government.
The room with brick walls and a flag and in the middle of nowhere underneath in the ocean.
Machine that was able to read the size of your dicks.
Yeah.
Huge.
View for yourself this incredible testimony before the UN takes it down.
You used to work at Area 51.
That sounds like something YouTube would take down just because.
When did things get weird?
Well, the way this went down was, I only got hands-on with one of them, and I was fucking an alien. It produced a little discharge from the bottom. It was exciting.
I'm going to say this was edited, you know, just like shifted. Really well done, though.
You know, we turn the lights on, and all these guys are there, so...
What in the fuck is this?
We have, you know, actual hardware from another civilization. It's a big...
Is he just, like, making fun of him?
Live in a house? That's bullshit. I like just swinging around on trees.
Absolutely.
We are the sex organs of the machine world. But for people who don't know, let's give them the bullet points. How tall are you?
I'm 5'10".
You don't seem to have any muscle.
You know,
almost like a frame. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
Well, the disc, the flying saucer that I worked on.
You know, the one thing I don't... understand is why a lot of people will go on to interviews with people who will do their absolute best to tear everything down around them. Like, it's the same concept of YouTubers who like to debate, go on debates against each other, especially when they know they don't really have much of a leg to stand on. They just get wrecked. And it's really interesting. It's interesting from a kind of seeing it from an outside perspective. But a lot of these people have to realize that when you go on to an interview of this kind, unless you're going to go, like, you know, let's say you're a flat earther, okay? Unless you're going to go talk to another flat earther, you're just going to be just bombarded with insane questions all the time. And there's just, like, no winning in any scenario. It doesn't matter what you actually believe. So I just don't know why people put themselves into that scenario.
I saw it sitting there, and I thought, oh, my God.
Hey, Bob, it's probably a good idea if you shut up. I worked underground with the aliens. They shot my hand off. They're underground. There's bases. They're shooting lasers through the Earth's crust, and they move them at light speed.
You big fucking...
What? I'm not even doing anything.
Drop dead.
Hey, why don't you come on out?
So I can't tell if this video is is edited in a specific way to make it both sides seem like I think he, because his t-shirt keeps changing, so I think it's just edited weird. But I never saw the interview, so I don't know exactly how much of a jerk he was to this guy.
To the Nevada desert.
Deal.
The fuck out. All right, that's it, folks. Good night.
These revelations were sent out all over the globe using beams.
Absolutely free.
And it started an incredible awakening, inseminating the people's brains with knowledge.
Who killed JFK?
Flooring them with the revelation of it all.
An orangutan
with a spear.
And soon they were
McDonald's is like $30 where I am now.
Curiosity.
Bigfoot is a human-animal hybrid.
All right, here's the Google searches for Area 51. That big spike there, that's when Joe Rogan put out his podcast. You get the idea.
Is this when a bunch of people decide to do that crazy viral thing, descend on Area 51 or whatever? I bet you that's going to pop up somewhere in this nonsense.
And you see, it reached the right man at just the right time. A 21-year-old named Matthew Roberts.
He had heard about aliens
in Area 51 before.
Read that whole thing?
And he believed. He wanted to see him. Real bad. But what could he do?
I think it was Asmongold's dad who actually really believes in aliens too. Or maybe it was Mudahar's dad. It's one of their parents, Mudahar or Asmongold. I don't remember exactly which one. But they had this whole thing where they brought them on their show for it.
How could he possibly get into Area 51 to check him out?
Oh, you know, it could be Charlie's dad. And Charlie.
Scenario
sounds like something Moist Critical would be.
If I ran into Area 51, I would be shot and killed. Scenario 2. If
you bring 1,000 people with you, maybe one person will make
me
it.
Me and all of my friends ran in. We'd both be killed.
All right, they did the dumb Naruto run thing, right?
Scenario 3. If there were so many of us, thousands, so much fodder that they eventually ran out of bullets, then someone surely is going to get through and touch the government in its special area. My God. Within minutes.
Yeah, okay, that's what this whole thing was. I've seen a few things on this one. I haven't seen any historian's video on it, but that's technically an idea. How many people are going to willingly run into effectively a cheese grater for you?
He was drafting a Facebook post. They can't stop all of us.
I'm willing to die for the government. Let's do this.
On September 20th, 2019, we'll all meet up at the Area 51 Alien Central tourist attraction.
Hey, he should have done this underneath a, not a GoFundMe, but it was before GoFundMe. What was the website you could use to make $500,000 potato salads? That wasn't GoFundMe, was it?
Coordinate our entry. If we Naruto run, we can move faster than their bullets. Let's see them aliens. This event then goes into the ether.
Which it should have just disappeared.
And from here, it was up to the Facebook algorithm gods to decide what would happen next.
Which is followed by yeah, sure, we'll just push this through the entire algorithm. There's enough stable people here. Oh, man. You know what's funny? This was 2019. Imagine if this was 2021 when everyone was going crazy from the pandemic.
There's a lot here to be excited about. I think this could be very positive for our society and economy.
People from all across the flat world were receiving the invite, and they began pressing...
Half the people think it's a dome, not just flat. still, the amount of people that showed up were pretty entertaining. But most of them went to like a different like party a town or two over. Yeah. Within. Imagine if you actually clicked RSVP and it became a legal binding contract. That would be a different a whole different scenario.
Just a couple of days, the event had picked up hundreds of thousands of attendees. People loved the idea so much, they began making memes about how they were going to raid the base.
That makes more sense. At least that's
so
fun.
Many I can barely show you a fraction of them, rapid firing them out like the bullets that would soon be gunning them down.
Yes.
And so the event spread.
One of those pictures that were popping by was from another web series called... Don't hug me, I'm scared.
And spread around the internet, eventually morphing into...
Everyone who is something is going to raid Area 51.
Young people from all over the globe are joining up to fight for the future.
Nigel, a runner.
Null Pointer, runner.
Stevens, agent.
Simon, a runner.
Freeman, 713. I am a sentinel.
Everyone's doing their part. Are you?
We have the ships. We have the weapon.
Captain, put his gun down!
We need soldiers. We need you all.
And just like that, the game was on. At time.
Before we do this, please tell me that that whole montage of Naruto runs were for all different events. Please tell me that was for all different events. I know a lot of people never even showed up to this thing, but... cringe. All right.
Here's the new campaign. You're going to...
Okay, we can actually watch these, so... I got it, it's fine. We'll just watch them.
Love it.
To be or not to be.
Plans disappear. Dreams take over.
I live. I laugh. I nod. Nod on every device like a blank canvas.
Okay, see, I actually like ads like these because they're not... They're just not like, you know, hey, you should go sign up underneath my name. And, you know, like, example, if I ever get sponsored by anyone, just bypass it. I'm telling you now, just bypass my ad because it's going to be boring. I already can't even read a script right, so we'll see what type of train wreck that is. At least this is entertaining, and I'd almost watch it as a TV show.
It can be here and anywhere.
Jam, a man of fortune.
Will you break these chains?
But wherever I go, there you are.
NordVPN.com/internethistorian.
No, thanks. Look, I just...
Yeah. There's just an idea. I know what you want. You want the female audience, and I know women.
Wait. Is he doing a bunch of, like, ad runs? Or not ad runs. Like, idea runs in front of executives in Hollywood?
To you, m'ladies. Have you heard about NordVPN? You should get access to the international Netflix catalog. Never miss another episode of The Handsome Man Show. Oh, don't you hate it when your dishwasher gets region locked? No more. Oh, I feel so safe in NordVPN.
You know, it's probably not going to be long till appliances can be region locked.
And big, strong arms, especially with their new product.
You'll have to use a VPN
protection.
To get your fridge online.
It protects me from malicious sites and downloads and trackers and intrusive ads. So think pink. Think NordVPN.com/internethistorian.
Around it.
Because the V in VPN stands for the jump.
I think we've heard enough.
Fine. All right, I'll do the ads you like. Get Nord. Ooh, you can use some threat protection. Take your online safety more seriously. Ah, have you heard about their amazing prices?
NordVPN.com/internethistorian.
Tell them who's sent you.
D40 on the grill.
Ad over.
Jeez.
Welcome to the mission brief. Let's do a bit of background on Area 51. Secret of
right. I really like I was going to say the stupid name. I really like what Internet Historian does with
Welcome to the mission.
All their little like brief. Edits and things.
Let's do a bit of background on Area 51.
Right here, like this. Electricity, yep. Water, yep. Internet 7G. Uh-oh. Everyone's going to die from that. Owner, no one knows.
Secret military base, first developed in 1955. This is what it looks like on
Wikipedia.
Google Maps. It's approximately this big. Total area size, 51. And the volume, a big mystery. Until 1997, the government refused to even acknowledge that it existed. That is, until they were forced to by lawsuit. That lawsuit was about the death of two men who were former employees. And how did they die? Well, not aliens, but rather toxic fumes from burning garbage. Yeah, so what they would do is burn a whole bunch of cool, high-tech refuse on the lot.
Okay, I was like, were they just burning regular trash? No, they were probably not burning regular trash.
Let the deadly smoke blow downwind, and the staff was stuck breathing it in. A few years later, bing, bing, bong, cancer. Other than that, the public hasn't really been told
Everything
anything.
Gives you cancer
so
at this
all
point.
People can do is speculate
like
as to what
soda.
The hell is going on in there.
I think that they are keeping remnants of a UFO there.
We don't know if it's aliens. We don't know if it's time travel. We don't know if there's minions in there.
Virtual reality.
Yeah, if it's time travel, just go back to the very beginning and just end the human race.
Seems so incredibly sexy.
But what has been leaked is that they do test flights on new alien craft.
You motherfucker, don't you tease me.
Produce new alien tech. Breed the latest version of the newest, gayest frog.
Ah,
do not
great.
Get it confused with Roswell. That's over here. Area 51's over here. And the final thing that we know.
Anyone ever watch the TV show Eureka? It's really funny because Roswell and Eureka and Area 51 all had like major science competitions against each other. So that was pretty funny. Let's see. What do we know about Area 51? They do test. Okay. Producing. Okay, we just went through this.
Is that security is top notch. Mm. They have that thing locked down.
Oh, no. Military-grade locks. That will be broken into by the lock-picking lawyer in 15 seconds.
You want to break in anyway. Okay, but it's going to require some research. And the first thing to find out, has anyone ever tried breaking in before?
Probably.
Yes, several times. In fact, in January of 2019, an unnamed man broke through security barriers and drove 8 miles into the base. He got out of his car with a metal cylinder in his hands, and the military opened fire. He was shot dead at the scene.
What a weirdo.
And there was this time when a film crew from the BBC was arrested for trying to get in.
This is BBC News.
This time when a vacationing family of four went on.
Okay, this one looks like they made a mistake.
Off track?
Yeah. BBC probably deserved it, though.
The idea. You're not messing around.
Put your fucking hands up. I'm not going to tell you again.
But there's one story to top them all. And we'll disguise his identity, but he is my personal hero. The month is November. The location, Las Vegas. And the protagonist, a professional limo driver. Now,
really?
He's more than a little unhinged. Okay. He decides to start harassing and sending death threats to a lawyer, whom we think was going to represent his defense for this incident. If you've ever seen this TikTok, that's our boy doing donuts and driving backwards down the Las Vegas Strip. Anyway, fast forward 3 weeks.
Okay, that's great. But why would you threaten your own lawyer?
Wait.
Threaten the prosecution.
It's like 6 in the morning and this guy is already doing donuts at a car park near the airport.
I mean, definitely
then he decides
sealed, probably.
To drive from the car park into
Unless
the airport
he, like, smashed
itself.
Into it.
A fence? No problem. He drives right through it and onto the runway. He's just
Mental
driving
break.
Around, whizzing between planes, almost crashing several times, before eventually parking on a ramp.
All right, we gotta go
At
find this,
this
video.
Point, he jumps out, puts on a clown mask,
yeah.
and storms right
Mental
up to
break.
A private jet. He announces, aggressively, to the flight staff that there is a bomb in his limo. Quote, I have a fucking bomb. I'm going to blow this place
Jesus,
up.
This guy's crazy.
His plan? To commandeer this private jet and take it to Area 51.
Mm.
However, as sound as this plan was, the quick response by police meant that it wasn't really working out.
Yeah.
So he bails back to his limo, tries to make an escape, until eventually police catch up with him. At that point, he is quickly arrested.
Okay.
They take him in for questioning, and he starts telling them.
Did they let
That's
him
right,
go?
I did it to see the aliens. He also told them to refer to him as the Chosen One.
Mental break or drugs? Maybe both? I don't know.
And by the way, I have high security clearance. Also, I'm involved with the mob. And someone
that
owes me millions of dollars. Later on, the bomb defusal crew checks out the limo and determines that it's just a fire extinguisher with a bunch of wires and duct tape and some fairy lights. Now, at some point, he gets out, presumably on bail, and CNN reporters walk up to him and start asking him questions. No statements from me, he says, but you should talk to my lawyer. And then he proceeds to hand them the business card of the...
of the lawyer he threatened?
lawyer that he's been sending death threats to for the last 3 weeks. Amazing. After all that, the judge ordered that he be sent to a mental hospital
there we go.
For assessment. Or so they say.
Ooh, how convenient.
Okay, so people have really died trying to do this. That means we're going to have to be a little more covert. So over at Area 51 HQ, the military can see that Facebook numbers have reached 1
okay.
million.
I was wondering if they just brought that up, then they were actually going to go back to it. But yeah, this was insane at the time.
And it doesn't take a genius to calculate that even if just 1% of them show up, that's... Wait a minute. Run those numbers. This many people. In a crowd that big, there's bound to be at least a few who'll do something stupid. In fact, the military took it so serial that they even went over the nuances of Naruto running. This is a real slide, by the way, and it required a real demonstration, of course. Now some
okay, good.
Undercover operative then took a photo of that brief.
He's probably like watching. He's like, what the heck is this? This is dumb as heck. But I mean, yeah, there's going to be, if 10,000 people actually had shown up, I don't know what would have happened. Jeez.
And they uploaded it to Reddit.
They intend to use our tactics against us.
All right. So if the military decides to do this,
right,
things could go pretty badly for Matthew. So Matthew goes back to his mind palace.
Think.
Let's not keep saying it's a raid. Instead, let's do a music festival. This would give Matthew an alibi and throw authorities off the scent.
I'm willing to music festival.
Yeah, that just makes it so he doesn't get in trouble for this nonsense.
For the government, let's do this.
All right, Reddit, here it is. Alien Stock 2019. The official EDM party, hosted by Matthew Roberts, set to take place in Rachel, Nevada.
I would never, ever host it. I would be like, yeah, I'll go. I'm not setting this up, though.
A town that just so happens to neighbor Area 51.
Doesn't it have like 100
it
people in this?
Oh, 50 total residents and practically no infrastructure. Perfect. Yeah, nice try, fellas, said the military. And the captains and the generals all started planning their own EDM party. With the deep state.
Mm-hmm.
Three groups in particular. Introducing Group E. The E local state police. Police have their work cut out for them because, owing to this party, they think there could be upwards of 50,000 people.
There's no way, well, obviously 50,000 people didn't show up, but this town has, like, what, one officer?
Descending
maybe
upon
two?
The little town of Rachel.
Lincoln County commissioners trying to tackle the tough task of preparing for a potential inundation of people. And Sheriff Kerry Lee has less than 30 deputies.
Oh.
The county declares a state of emergency.
Okay, so 30's, I guess, probably just due to the sheer amount of distance and land, you need more people. But and I assume this is a few other areas around here. The 30 for one tiny little area seems so high, so I'm going to guess
they
it's a little different.
They allocated an extra $250,000 worth of enforcement for the weekend of the raid, as well as an extra 300 police officers and paramedics.
That many people are going to stress the community to the point that it's just...
There's no way...
We can't...
I think the problem with this was is a lot of these people didn't realize how the internet worked. Everyone will RSVP. They're not actually going to do anything. No, barely anyone ever actually goes anywhere. We're all terminally online.
Cope with it.
This is some of the most exciting stuff that I've ever gotten to work on. And I'm...
Hold on, Mark.
Group D.
That guy.
The defense.
And I'm going to take up my gun and shoot somebody.
So the FBI agents that showed up, they showed up at 10 a.m. They contacted my mom, and you're like, so she texted me, she's like, FBI's here, answer your phone. So I was kind of scared at this point, but...
This report from the Nevada Department of Public Safety was released last year, and it features some very interesting details. For example, they called a group...
It makes sense that they would actually show up at his house for setting this thing up, because, you know, that is technically a government's facility, so... if you somehow convinced tens of thousands of people to potentially show up to... front of the building, yeah, you're gonna get in trouble.
Group of YouTubers trying to plot a tracker on the bus that goes to and from the base.
Which YouTubers were this?
We're gonna pull an epic prank.
Highly illegal.
And Johnny Somali?
You may not be that surprised to hear that the military isn't actually that worried about people breaking into the base. Turns out, they have automated weapons.
Yeah.
Not automatic weapons. Automated, whatever that is. No, instead, they think there's potential that real terrorists will, you know, do the thing or a thing. So, counterterrorism was given a budget to sweep for chemical, biological, radiological, and explosive material.
No, I mean, from a technical standpoint, that makes sense. If you have, you know, 10,000 random internet users, you could easily hide a few people in there. Yeah.
Although, nothing was found. And there's just one last group getting involved as well. The corporate press.
Of course.
Disinformation agents in the mainstream media were getting involved.
Hey, if it makes
money.
They
immediately started warning people not to raid.
Use of lethal force authorized.
Spouting contempt for the Stormers.
What started as a joke, Facebook event, quickly turned into a phenomenon. Reaching
well, it began as a joke, but now it's turned into something much more serious.
Astroturfing campaigns by late night ha-ha man number 1 through 7.
It's much more likely they'll see them tasers.
You know what's funny? I wonder how much money was spent defending the 500, no, it was probably like 50 people who actually showed up to this thing.
Ha ha ha, laugh it all up. It's just a big joke.
People who say they're interested just keeps growing.
Faster than their bullets, let's see them aliens.
And they weren't afraid to give some of the biggest, brainest takes you've ever heard.
It's not clear the 1.1 million Facebook followers.
No, they would have never shown up. It's like a change.org, not policy, petition, all right? How many of those have actually ever done a thing? Maybe 3?
Who said they are going to storm Area 51 are real and not Russian bots.
You're goddamn
genius! Yeah, I mean, they're definitely...
Fine.
There's probably
we'll
definitely
make you
bots.
Take us seriously.
There's definitely a lot of idiots, though, that are just like 4chan users... Reddit users who were like, yeah, I'll RSVP to that. No, I'm not going. Well, I'm going to do it anyway, though.
Let the training begin.
I think this is the part that kind of made it worse.
And speaking of that, I think it's time for my workout.
And so the Raiders began training.
We train for Area 51. So let's go.
Sandwich.
They began pushing their body.
Go on, make it happen.
Pushing their will.
Yeah, I think this was the problem. Everyone just made these videos for fun on YouTube just to get views and things like that, never attempting to ever even go to this. And the government's like, nope, we're going to take this seriously.
Pushing their spirits.
Dominate!
Pushing their minds.
Stronger than resist!
And yeah, you'll have
their
the 100
and families,
700 crazy idiots that go
to the list.
Who wants to come with me to kick some alien butt? In September, join me. We out.
And that's what fitness will be like in the metaverse.
As we zero in on the day of the raid, the count is up to 2 million attendees, and that puts us on par with the world's largest standing army. So to coordinate all of these troops...
That'd be literal insanity if 2 million people
will
showed
need
up.
A battle strategy.
Lay it on us.
From r/memes, intel was being filtered down to the troops.
groups such as the Minecraft YouTubers, the Normans, the Wii.
The best part is all these maps were being made just for fun. Just being posted all over the place to mess with the military.
Facebook moms, the Kyles, the Chads, the crack kids.
Is this a 5 o'clock free crack giveaway?
Florida man, the Australians,
Florida man,
the gay Reddit mods.
Okay, this thread is locked.
And the North Korean defectors. They all had their role to play. So, Godzilla comes in from the east while the Australians make a distraction that allows the Minion cosplayers to breach from the south. Of course, these very serious strategies would have to be disguised as
Cthulhu cultists,
so that they could be spread across YouTube, Reddit,
they would be
at TikTok,
Area 51.
Without the threat
That's not even
of
a whole
being...
section they go to.
Although, not everyone was as tech-savvy. Authorities managed to nab one of the main cartographers, and they pressured him into an interview on the television.
It took me a total of 5 minutes to put this image together. It was sort of...
I can't believe... Okay.
Sort of like a battle strategy, almost.
It was completely rooted in satire.
That was just completely rooted in satire.
And no one should raid, this is just completely a joke.
And completely just a joke.
Mission counting sheeple complete. You can take him out. No. Okay, so remember how we're not raiding anymore and it's just a music festival? Wink, wink, wink.
I'm sure that was just awful too.
Bad news.
Okay, so it sounds like you maybe are looking at changing venues. Possibly.
Possibly.
It's all up in the air. We're putting Maddie on the spot here.
There's a lot of challenges. So.
Hey, he got to go on an actual TV show and maybe get paid for it. So kind of worked out for this guy, because I highly doubt he actually went to the actual event.
But it's 2 weeks away, so.
Aside from the music festival.
Kind of got to figure it out, I guess, somewhat soon, right?
Yeah, it's all kind of falling apart. Mm-hmm. See, Matthew had organized Alien Stock with a few other people, but his main business partner was Connie West.
I didn't plan it. It planned me.
But Matthew is the headliner. His name is attached to everything. And he's starting to get worried about a fire festival type situation in the desert.
Be a Firefest 2.0.
He wanted to make sure there's plenty of water, food, security, insurance,
Geico,
et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And here, deals and communications start to break down. Eventually, there's a lawsuit, and it's kind of boring.
Things that they were supposed to pay for, I'm stuck paying for.
Who cares?
We're going to skip it. But the TLDR is that they had a disagreement, and Connie said,
I don't have to prove to you what I spent. You didn't sign a fucking contract with me to begin with. So guess what? I don't need to prove to you a...
Well, if you guys never spent... If you guys never made a contract, then... Does he owe you any money?
Motherfucking thing.
And Matthew said... Matthew then took $70,000 worth of sponsorship money and declared Alien Stock and Rachel cancelled. But then, at the same time, Bud Light walks in.
It's the Bud Light.
Of course it's Bud Light. But if he took $70,000 of sponsor money, wouldn't he still have to pay that back? If not... That was a good grift.
You say, hey, why not do it here? In the Vegas. It has plenty of lighting, indoor plumbing. It has everything. Matthew said yes. And then using the website for Alien Stock, he told everyone to not go to Rachel and instead to go to Vegas. Welcome to Alien Stock Las Vegas. Sponsored by Bud Light. And also Paul
Nuff, sounds like something Bud Light would do.
Connie was left to pick up the pieces. However, she would not be discouraged so easily. She decided to press on.
It's going to be a great party. No matter what, it's going to be a great party.
She had to take full control of the event and Rachel, dipping into her savings and even mortgaging her home.
I'm working out of my own pocket.
I think this is a liability. I'm out.
Why would you mortgage your home for this?
It's worth doing a very fast recap, because there's an event in Rachel that's been declared cancelled but also not cancelled. Also, I forgot to mention there's an event in Hico that isn't cancelled but it will be on the second day. There's also that third festival in Las Vegas, which has the former promoter of the first one, and they both share the same damn name. And none of this has anything to do with the actual raid on Area 51, which is here, which has several gated entrances, by the way, and none of them have been declared the official gathering point. Confused?
And they all have automated
defenses
of some kind.
It's a goddamn mess. People, rightfully, put the whole thing in the too hard basket, and instead of going to one in the middle of nowhere, just go to the one in Vegas.
Okay, the Vegas one. I wonder if the Vegas one actually turned out to be good. Because a lot of people randomly on the strip could join that one.
Let's fast forward to the weekend of the raid. For better or worse, Rachel is about to open its doors to the millennials.
Hell yeah!
Aliens, stop!
Encore now has come to an abrupt halt.
Don't let the aliens get you, Ken.
Do you believe in aliens?
I don't.
Run! Get out of here!
Oh, you know, I want to hear about the alien liberal agenda. They could have some good talking points. We don't know.
To protect my mind from interference.
We have a wanderer.
Don't let me leave, Murph!
It could be anything, Stock. But it's alien stuff.
How do you see walking with that shirt up over your head like that?
I don't.
And the first ones are supposed to be always, you know, the best ones.
Paranormal lawyer. PhD level field investigator.
The first ones are always the worst ones. Haven't we learned anything? There's the Tumblr convention, DashCon. There are a ton of random, like, Star Trek cons that have failed. I'm sure there's My Little Pony conventions that have failed. What was the other one that... Oh, FurFest. That was a bad one.
Stuff in downtown Las Vegas. Did they change the name or is it still Alien Stock?
I think I'm on my highest high I've ever been in my life. Look at it.
And we are taking a look kind of the area here. You've done a lot of work in a very short period of time.
The security's here, the medical's here, the food is here, the people are here. And most importantly,
she mortgaged her house and is out like 80 grand.
Hope it was worth
it. Hope it was worth it, the toilets.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
I mean, if she had fun, I guess that's all
that
really matters.
It wasn't quite the event that they had hoped for, but they did do a commendable job of acting retarded for the news.
This is the most fun I've ever had in my life.
I do.
Here for scientific reasons.
This is like the most millennial thing.
I guess 100 people showed up. That's not horrible. Depending on how much you wasted
that's
on that,
happened.
Though.
But don't let's forget, Hiko.
Yeah, I want to see this
Hiko.
One.
No one knows how to pronounce it.
I don't know
this
if I've
event
seen this
was
one.
Being hosted by George Harris of the Alien Research Center.
The owner of the center is Las Vegas businessman George Harris, creator of Alien Tequila.
If you want to have fun.
At least he seems to
if
have
you
money.
You want to have a great look. It's a great day.
Basecamp was equipped with a vendor village of 10 food trucks, a gift shop, and 3-time Grammy Award winner Paul Oakenfold. For some reason.
I was told there's a lot of people coming.
Well, right now, things are kind of slow at the Hiko event here, so that's kind of a disappointment.
Now, Hiko Basecamp was expecting somewhere between 1,000 and 20,000 attendees. It's quite a range.
Maybe 50 people.
Okay, so 50 people showed up. Well, 100 people showed up at the first one. You know what's funny is you would expect ticket prices to be in place here for this one. So, you could even do free tickets, I guess, or just do like $5 tickets. That way you at least get an idea of who is actually coming. But I guess the upside with this one, with the Hiko one, is the businessman, probably even if he loses money on this, which he probably did, you know, it probably won't matter in the grand scheme of things.
People here clapping some alien cheeks.
Yeah, but no cheeks are clapped.
Yeah, where's
at
the
all.
Cheeks?
None.
Where's
zero
the cheeks?
Cheeks?
This is like the first of a big thing.
But it wasn't. In fact, it seems as though the majority of the attendees were actually the press.
One lady believed that her parents is actually alien.
So, after the first night, they decided to cut their losses and canceled the whole event.
You know, the producers of the show, it's very, very, very expensive. And it just didn't make sense.
Because they...
Okay, so the Vegas one looks like a 3,000 people
went
to.
All of the attendees were stolen by...
Alien Stock 2019!
All right, so first guy, smart. Jump ship, talk to Bud Light and be like, yeah, let's do it in Vegas. Smart. And then apparently leave with $70,000 in sponsorship money.
We're going to go out to Rachel, and then we decided that we didn't want to get stuck in the desert.
Smart.
As much as I like Mad Max, I don't want to live it.
The Las Vegas Alien Stock, sponsored
by
Bud
Light.
Yeah, if
you're going to do that, at least go to Coachella.
They've got carnival rides, photo ops, video games, and even a pool. Huh? No running.
Who could have predicted this? You make a post at 2 a.m. with on a page that has 62 likes, and now you have thousands of people that are ready to come out to your show. It's absolutely amazing.
Okay, let's see what happens here.
Military HQ in Anna Orlando.
10
operations
people.
Were ramping up. They're adding more guards, upping the security, and enforcing a no-fly zone across the county.
I'm surprised there isn't a no-fly zone there already. But yeah, I mean, I guess it might just be all random hype for that one. But I mean, after Alien Stock in Vegas, I bet you everyone was just too drunk, hungover, and it just had fun with it. And then, what do you think? 10 people showed up to this? 25, maybe?
Infiltrating Raider groups.
And $10 million?
Next to an officer and not even know it. There's a undercover presence here.
And they were giving stern warnings from the PR team. They posted this tweet.
Like a name on the soldiers from Churchill.
Will see if they attempt to raid Area 51 today.
Sorry to disappoint you, Yugi. You triggered my trap card.
Millennials immediately.
All right, it would have been really funny if that's a whole that whole trap card sequence actually said millennials in it. That would have been
they
really
seized upon the tweet, doing what they do best by pretending to be offended, successfully having the tweet taken down and forcing a public apology.
I'm retarded.
All right, this video is getting very long. Let's hurry up to the main event. The raid.
Hey, are you coming?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I ran out of gas on the way there. It's just too expensive now. Oh, I got called in for work. Sorry. Yeah, I just lied. Oh, jeez. I'm honestly surprised that this audio wasn't somehow acclaimed. All right, this is probably the best editing sequence I've ever seen from the Internet Historian. It's like playing a game on the N64 while watching Naruto at the same time. Oh, of course. Of course. I honestly want to know how long this sequence took to make, okay? This is crazy. I was gonna do jumps and across little things. Nope, hoverboard. Oh, drones.
Smoking these meats.
Side note, there's a pretty interesting drone company called Andrel that uses kinetic drones, which are like basically flying bowling balls to smash into other drones. I don't know, just small little tidbit there. It's a pretty cool company.
The toilets are here.
Oh my gosh, that whacked out. I could actually see that being real. I could totally see this being real. I went back a little too far, but I like how the water bottles were up there too. Yep. That would be perfect. We need to talk about this whole thing's a war crime.
Yasuki Shouri.
Okay, put the key in the
hole. Orokana-san, you have died in the
How did you see what it said? It doesn't say alien tech, it says Aleem tech. Jeez. With an Alienware computer? So just kill everyone? You need 3 million people, not two. Okay. Before this last little part finishes, can we appreciate that this last part is effectively a 6 or 7 minute full editing montage that probably took longer to edit than this entire video, and maybe a few others combined? Monster? Okay. Wow. No, just, I would watch a 30-minute video of this. An elevator. I'd recognize one anywhere. Wait a second. Okay, we gotta see the elevator. Bigfoot room. Polyp. Epstein security footage. Parking. I'm sure there's a few more at the very top.
Thank you for saving us. We are so grateful and horny. And yes, we wish...
Yep. This is exactly what I expected. This is... Yep.
...to be your big titty goth alien GFs. And you won't be a virgin Reddit browser anymore.
Oh, you'll still be a virgin Reddit browser. They're just gonna wipe your mind.
I wasn't quite like that, but it was pretty close to something like that.
It is exactly like that. That's exactly what happened.
Though, I guess you could say that only a small group showed up to the main gates themselves.
Pretty decent group.
Welcome, million people!
Of over 2 million people, in total only about 200 actually went. But it's not about the quantity, it's the...
Quite a few people showed up, and luckily they probably weren't shot
quality
down.
Quality that counts.
Nice outfit. Geez.
Wow.
Now throw them over!
People mostly behaved themselves.
I mean, I think it's awesome. You guys are following the laws, following directions, so. Yeah.
But they weren't about to leave without a consolation prize. Get some of the Area 51 soil. Top secret rock. Top secret rock.
Where are they?
I guess it's not the equivalent of stealing a rock from the moon from a lab or something.
You can have it. It's from Area 51.
Thank you.
Okay.
Also present at the raid were a few YouTubers.
Uh-huh.
So I came here to get myself a...
Okay, so I could see YouTubers, especially YouTubers, doing something stupid and getting themselves shot. I could actually see a YouTuber getting themselves in a lot more trouble because The YouTubers that go out into real life are insane psychopaths in a lot of ways. At least the ones that we find out about on the news.
We're here to rescue the aliens!
It's like, it's like Halloween, but we're just annoying people.
Wait, was that?
From Area 51.
I think they're showing
okay.
Also
who
present
they
at the raid
are
were
up
a few
on top.
YouTubers.
I want
so
to see.
I came here to get
okay, I don't know who Elixir is.
We're here to rescue
or
the
this
aliens.
Weirdo.
It's like Halloween.
Okay, so this was a Tozy. Okay. Is there 1.21 million subs? I think they're like 1.6 now. They go and travel around a lot to a lot of random conventions. Like, they went to Ace Fest, I think. And I haven't seen the video, but I think we should watch it because I hear it was awful.
But we're just annoying people.
Okay, to be fair, you know, YouTubers just annoy people.
Are you guys gamers? Play games? No? You watch anime?
Yeah, so you got the rebellious youth, and then you got people trying to lure E.T. into a cage with Reese's Pieces and stuff. That's a pretty good summary of the crowd that you have out here this weekend.
But respect to the true heroes. Security. For keeping everyone... Ah, just kidding. It's the guys who got underneath this fence. God bless them.
Gotcha.
Oh, no!
And this cameraman, whose foot raided the base.
Yeah, I got it.
That'd been so bad if he stuck his foot back there in a sniper shot.
That's so good, I see.
And this random woman who decides to just start walking. Police, right there. No one's stopping her. Oh my god. She's gonna make it. She's going home. Yeah. She gets charged for trespassing and receives a $1,000 fine.
Jeez. That's actually a pretty small fine for her.
But soon it was time to wrap up.
The dorm is over.
Because everyone's moms were there to pick them up. And if they were late again, there would be big trouble.
Hey, good night, everyone.
No, my mom would never pick me up. She'd be like, you're on your own. If you don't come back, well, I guess they don't have to pay for college.
Everyone. Yeah, I'm going to sleep now.
Psych, it's not over.
There's one more thing that I want to tell you about today.
Because storming Area 51 would go on to inspire a plethora of other events. The storming of Loch Ness. That thing can't...
Really? It actually created a bunch of alternate ones? Okay, Loch Ness one's pretty interesting.
From all of us.
We think we have seen it.
What did it look like?
It looks like a big stone.
Over 27,000 said they were going. Actual number 6.
Hey, great.
Okay, but storm the Bermuda Triangle, why not? It can't drown all of us.
How would you know
and
how
potentially
many people went?
Millions actually went, but the evidence would be lost, so how would you know?
I am under the water. Please help me.
Or how about storm the Vatican?
That
they
would
can't
be
molest us all. Interesting twist on that one, though. Someone canceled.
That's actually really funny. That's bad, but that's funny.
The event. But overall, everyone had a pretty good time.
Yeah, I mean...
Isn't that what...
For something that was started off as a joke, that actually was one of the more successful conventions. Actually, technically... Okay, maybe not the second one. The first one you could say was partially successful because 100 people actually showed up. Aside from, you know, her having to mortgage her house, probably. But the one in Vegas seemed successful, and that was the guy who originally started it with a random post.
Area 51 was really built for. It's something like that, you know what I mean? I haven't quite...
The Heroes of 51. So yeah, the Vegas one was actually really useful. Has anyone really been far, even has decided to even go? What?
Remember when I said that we were going to do shorter videos and also
no, they're getting
more
longer.
Frequently? Looks like you fell for it. Da ha ha ha.
Yeah, I remember the first video, and he's like, "Yeah, I'm going to do 2 to 3 of these a week." It's put up like 40 videos in like 7 years. Which is fine. I mean, this one's a long video, but he's also put out even longer videos, which we'll definitely be checking out.
See you in the next one in 2 years.
Yeah, there we go. That's about
or
right.
Or check out the Incognito Mode channel. That has a lot more upload.
Goodbye. Yeah, I mean, if he had stuck with just one channel, I could see him having more uploads. But a lot of people like to stick within their niches. Obviously, I'm a reaction channel, so I jump all over the place. But the majority of people stay within a niche. So, yeah, but we'll check out his other channels as well. That was pretty entertaining. Man, a lot of people are stupid, but at least they had fun, and no one died in this one. Can't say a lot for some of the theater episodes that we've seen. Have a good day, everyone.